Department of Engineering, Troy White. Hey, Troy.
How you doing, Bart?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Thanks for having me back.
Yeah. I would like to get updates for our viewers from you on all the things going on.
Yeah, we got a lot going on. We're already under construction. We've been under construction for a while. So getting through town right now, it's pretty much impossible.
Yeah.
I shouldn't say that because it's not impossible, but there's a lot going on. You know, it's inconvenient, but it's a good thing. It means our city's getting rebuilt.
Yeah, it's because you actually have some very high traffic routes that are either under construction or bordering construction.
Right.
We're going to start. We're going to look at some of these projects. We're
okay.
going to start on Brown Street, and I think a lot of people have observed some things going on over there.
Yeah, that one's it's we're well underway. We're going to be repaving the street, but before we do, we're building a mixed-use path along the east side of Brown Street. That'll connect the path from Cascades to the path on Michigan that brings you downtown. So it'll be open for any non-motorized users, bikers, bladers, rollerblade people, walkers, and it'll provide a connectivity from the park to downtown.
Nice, then. I see you've got a lot of it already poured.
Yes. And we probably got a couple more weeks of this concrete work to do, and then when that's done, we'll mill and resurface the street, and the street will be brand new. Well, it won't be a brand new street, but it'll have a new surface on it. It'll look new for a while.
And this section of Brown Street, it's never had sidewalks.
It has never had sidewalks, so we're filling in a gap, but while we're filling it in, we're kind of not doing the minimum. We're creating that that non-motorized opportunity. Because really, if you are on a bike, you don't want to be on Brown Street.
No.
It's not that kind of street. So building that path and making that extra room for them, it's a good thing.
Yeah, and we've talked about this before. That portion of Brown Street's been confusing. And at one time, it actually had marked four lanes.
Yes.
Yeah, remember?
At one time, it got reduced to three lanes with some bike lanes on the side. But even with the three lanes, the road is so wide, it made these really wide travel lanes. And the lanes are as wide as on a highway. Well, on a highway, we go, 75 miles an hour?
Yeah.
We don't want that type of thing, in our city. I mean, yes, it is a busy road, but, when we build the streets to an appropriate width with the appropriate lane widths, people drive a little more appropriately, right?
Safer,
calms them down a little bit.
So the width of the street that goes from Morrell to the park, that will match the new?
No, because from the park up to Morrell, that's a two-lane road.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, it's all residential, and it'll stay two lanes. From Morrell up to Michigan Avenue, that will be a three-lane road.
Center turn lane.
Correct, with a center turn lane. Similar to what it has been for a long time, but with the lane widths.
Yeah, you need that center turn lane with Washington and Franklin.
Right,
lane,
especially with that corridor being non-residential in use, with all the businesses along there, and then having the turn lanes at Morrell and at Michigan. So it makes sense.
Awesome. So that'll be, what's the timeline on that?
I think we probably got about another month to go.
Okay, nice.
And then we'll be out of there.
Yep, that'll be nice.
One thing that it's a little confusing right now, because while the city's contractor is working on the path, Consumers is out there doing gas main replacement.
Ah.
So, and AT&T is out there replacing telephone poles and moving telephone poles. So while our project isn't that invasive a project, you put all three together, mm-hmm. and there's a whole lot of action going on out there. And that's why the traffic has constricted so much. The intent was, to have the utility work done first, and then their city's contractor working, we could keep two lanes of traffic open. Well, it didn't happen that way, and everyone's working at once, so we had to put up we had to reduce it to a single travel lane. That way properties remain accessible, but it also provides a safe work zone for everybody working out there.
Avoid the area. Now AT&T, they're coming back after a project is done, like at Greenwood and 4th, they're still, they should set up a little branch office there. They're there so much.
when we rebuild these signals, the standards have changed so much. It used to be that the signals hung diagonally, the span hung diagonally across the intersection. Well, now they're always a box that go around the intersection. That's the new standard. That's what we're required to build. And it makes sense. It makes things more visible. Mm-hmm. It's easier to maintain. The problem is with that back span going around the intersection, all the wires that we're used to, you know, going along a street, they conflict now.
Yeah.
And I don't think that's something that the utility companies were necessarily prepared for when these standards started changing. So whenever we do a signal, and we do most of them, we do all ours with the mast arm configuration. But even if we did new mast arms and used wires, we'd still have that problem. So whenever we do a signal, when we've been doing a lot of them, it's hard on AT&T and those guys to get to get out of the way.
Well, sure looks nice. I mean, it's nice, clean. It's got, even got a, you know, as we've talked, a big city feel about these intersections with the illuminated street names.
And I think as we get used to them, we start to realize, you know, when you're used to the diagonal span, what was the problem? It's what we're used to. But now that as you start getting more and more of the box spans with them going around the intersection, you really start to notice, like, the visibility of the signal. You know, it's much better now than it used to be. Even though difference. We didn't think we had a problem, now we realize, well, it could have been. Even though it wasn't a problem, it can be better.
Yeah. All right, now let's move on to another project, and that is Steward, which this is probably the last project you'll have on Steward.
This has been going on for a long time. I think we actually started, we've worked on Steward in like three different phases. We did the phase from Wildwood up to the railroad. Then we did from the railroad to Gansett, and now we're actually going under the railroad with our water main. It's just basically a project to upgrade the water main that goes under the railroad to tie into the new system on both sides. The existing water main is from the 19-teens, and it's undersized, and it just has to be done. So that's what we're doing right now. Right now, I think they're out there digging pits on both sides of the railroad. Then they'll lower a machine into one of the pits and they'll bore out under the railroad. We won't have to dig across the railroad. We wouldn't be allowed to if we wanted to.
You actually have to get permission from...
That's really what's taken us so long is making sure that we have all the permits in place with the railroad.
Wow, look at that.
Yeah, that we have the safety plan in place, that we have the railroad inspectors in place. The railroad is serious stuff, so that's why you have all these requirements. Mm-hmm. We've met all the requirements, but it's taken us a while to get here. I'll be glad when it's done.
Yeah, and you don't want to be the city that gets on national TV with a train derailment.
No, we do not. But, you know, there's they have their safety inspectors out there. They're we're actually doing, like, you do monitoring the rails to make sure they're not impacted. Mm-hmm. And, there's a lot of security measures in place to make sure everyone stays safe.
Good. Another big project happening on, while this street isn't a high-travel street, Perrine, it does intersect at East Michigan Ave.
Yes, yeah, we're doing a local street on Perrine from Michigan to Burr. It has impacted the people who live like on that street a lot lately, but it hasn't impacted the rest of us until now. Right now we're up on Michigan Avenue. We got Michigan Avenue reduced down to two lanes so that we can make our connections of our storm sewer and our water main to the pipes out on Michigan Avenue.
So this looks like a pretty major project for the street.
Yeah, this is like a full reconstruct with new water main, new sanitary sewer, and then we're going to rebuild the street with new curb and gutters and new pavement.
Ways to go.
Yeah, this is one of the streets where the sewer, the old sewer that we're replacing, was actually the brick sewer.
Huh.
Probably from, I'm guessing, 1907 or
That's
before.
Amazing.
But it's really neat to see. It's a neat old artifact, but it's also nice to get it replaced with something more reliable. But, you know, you look at the craftsmanship and how they must have, the work that went into building those brick sewers. It's interesting.
Yeah, without all that heavy machinery and everything, I don't know how they did stuff. And Brandon noted as he filmed these segments this morning that some of the motorists are not being very sensitive to the construction workers.
Well, we need to be sensitive to them. I mean, they're just out there trying to make a living, and they're making things better for us, but they got families and everything too. We've got all the signing up, we've got the advance warning up, there's all the orange barrels. There's really no way anybody wouldn't know there's something going on. I mean, the only reason someone would be speeding through and being unsafe is just not being considerate, you know?
Yeah.
I know we gotta drive through there like it's our families out there working, right?
Yep. Yeah, when you're standing there in a car, it whizzes by at 50 miles an hour.
Yeah,
you feel it. Those masked iron boxed intersections, how many are we going to have?
Ultimately, at some point, we got to upgrade all our signals at some point. We've really accelerated in probably the last, I'd say, 7 or 8 years. Probably 8 years ago, we started doing signals. I think there was a big push in the 80s, maybe, and a lot of signal work got upgraded in the 80s, mm-hmm. and then it just sat there. So a lot of our traffic signals are antiquated and less reliable. So whenever we get an opportunity, we've been doing signals. We got to do some catch up, but I just don't think they were a focus for a long time. It was easy to take the eye off the ball when we knew that our streets had mm-hmm. we have our street issues, but just because we have our street issues doesn't mean that our signals weren't also aging and getting antiquated and irrelevant, you know. So.
Yeah.
You're gonna keep seeing them going. I think in the last couple of years we've probably done 6 or 7. I hesitate to say off the top of my head, but I think about 30% of our signals have been upgraded. But that means we got a long way to go.
Yeah, and you can see there's a lot that are in process where they mm-hmm. Installed the bases.
Yeah, and really what it is, like you're talking about, we put the base in. It takes about a year, but from the time you order the steel pole until it actually arrives on the site, just due to, you know, supply chain considerations and the limited number of manufacturers and the processes that it goes through to get these things built. So there's a long lag time.
Will you be stopping the projects for the holiday weekend?
Yeah. Typically what happens is, especially on our federally funded jobs, they want all the constructions closed down by noon on Friday, mm-hmm. so that way the roads are open for travelers. But the same time, most of the guys who've been working for the contractors, they've been working 50, 60-hour weeks for a while.
Yeah.
And it's kind of a nice opportunity for those guys to get an extra, you know, get a 4-day weekend.
They
instead
need
of a 3-day
holiday
weekend
too.
Yeah. Well, they've earned it because, you know, they put a lot of hours in.
Well, we appreciate the update, all the work everyone's doing to make our city nicer and safer. Thanks for coming in.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
From the City of Jackson Engineering Department, Engineer Troy White. Up next,